bilingual story time. My name is Miss Camille.
Hola, yo soy Isela. Gracias por estar con nosotros. Aquí tenemos a Miss Camille.
And today we're going to be doing a fun spider craft together because we read The Spider by Elise Gravel with permission from Penguin Random House. And so Isela, do you want to help me kind of demonstrate our little spider craft that we're going to make? So this is a climbing spider, and when you pull apart the popsicle sticks you tie to the string, he climbs up.
Tenemos una arañita hoy porque Miss Camille nos compartió un cuento, The Spider. Entonces, el libro era todo sobre arañas. Aprendimos muchas cosas de ellas, cómo viven. Hoy la manualidad es sobre arañitas. Entonces, si quieren aprender cómo hacer esta arañita en casa, por favor, ven, seguir este video y les vamos a mostrar cómo hacerlo.
And it's very easy. I've got most of the pieces already cut out for us, but all you need to cut out are just some strips of paper. They don't even all have to be the same length. These are going to be the legs of the spider.
Entonces tienen que recortar tiritas. I forgot how to say legs in Spanish. Miss Camille, do you remember?
Yeah.
Patitas.
Patitas. Piernas, yeah.
Piernas, lo que quieran decir. Pero vamos a hacer sus patitas. Mm-hmm. Como ven, las arañas tienen varias patitas. Mm-hmm. Entonces vamos a recortar tiritas. Nosotros las recortamos que todas sean casi igual. Mm-hmm. Pero unas veces se ven chistosas si no son de la, mm-hmm. de la misma altura. So yeah. We cut up the strips and we have...
That's right. You need at least 8, but maybe you can do more than 8. You can kind of do whatever you want. It doesn't have to be like a real spider. But we've also got circles that are going to be our spider's body.
Entonces, las tiritas, nosotros vamos a recortar 8. Aquí tenemos muchas. Mm-hmm. Si ustedes quieren recortar más o ponerle menos, ustedes pueden hacer que su arañita se vea como ustedes quieran. Y recortamos unos círculos para hacer el cuerpo de la araña. So we have our circle here, which is the body. What else do we have here?
Yeah, so we've also got some googly eyes.
Tenemos unos ojitos locos.
And we've got kind of different sizes of them. Most of them are the same size, but there are some little ones too. Once again, you can make your spider look kind of funny by mixing up the sizes of eyes that you use.
Entonces, unos ojitos son más grandes, pues les puedo mostrar. Unos tan grandes, sé que no pueden ver tan cerca, y uno tan chiquito. Y unas veces se ven chistosos cuando le ponen unos diferentes.
And we've also got a couple of popsicle sticks, and these just help so that the strings don't go through the back of the spider, so they stay where you want them.
Aquí tenemos unos palitos para ayudarnos cuando queremos que la araña se mueva. Entonces, esos son los palitos que tenemos. Si no tienen estos, pueden usar cualquier cosa en casa, mm-hmm. pero estos son los palitos que vamos a usar para a la manualidad de hoy.
And then the last part of the materials that you're going to need are some little pieces of straws. They don't have to be a particular length, but these are about an inch.
Nosotros recortamos unos popotes. Están como una pulgada. Pueden recortarlos y no importa qué color son porque no se van a ver. Mm-hmm. Entonces, nomás comen un popote de plástico y lo recortan.
Mm-hmm. And you need at least 2 per spider.
Y van a necesitar 2 pedacitos de popote.
Okay, so Isela and I each have a body of our spider. And let's see, I think first we should probably put the legs on first. So we need 8 legs for our spider, right? So Isela, do you want to help me count in English and in Spanish? 8 legs out for you. 1.
1.
2.
2.
3.
3.
4.
4.
5.
5.
6.
6.
7.
7.
8.
Y 8.
Perfect. And I think I cut 16, so I should have 8 here.
Entonces, yo tenemos 2 círculos para el cuerpo de la araña y luego le vamos a pegar las 8 patitas. Vamos a usar mm-hmm. pegamento. Aquí vamos a usar como un glue stick.
Actually, we're going to use tape for the legs.
Never mind, guys. We're using tape. But so, you can use glue, right?
You could use glue. It's just tape is easiest because instead of having to kind of individually lay down the legs, you can line up the legs the way you want them and then just put tape right over top.
Okay.
So we're going to do 4 legs on each side.
Entonces, aquí estoy viendo cómo quiero poner las patitas. Entonces, las vamos a pegar atrás.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yes.
Entonces, si ustedes usan tape para poner las patitas, lo ponen de atrás y así no se van a ver.
Yeah, like I said, if you just lay down all the legs, then it's really easy to just lay the tape right over top and then press it down. Oh, got my legs a little misaligned.
Mine are misaligned, but I think they look funny though.
Yeah, it's okay if they're not perfect. As usual with these crafts.
¿Y su araña no tiene que ser color negra? ¿Pueden usar un papel diferente de diferente color? Your spider doesn't have to be black because spiders come in different colors. Mm-hmm. So you don't have to necessarily use black construction paper.
That's right. You could even do like a like white paper and color it in if you wanted to make it look like whatever your favorite spider is. All right, we've got our legs on our spiders. I love that. We cut them out about equal, but they look so different. All right, perfect. So now we got to put on the little eyeballs. So we talked about how many eyeballs did the book say that that spiders have, Isela?
I don't remember, pero sé que las arañas tienen muchos ojos.
I think they have 8.
Ooh.
We're not doing 8. We're doing 2.
Nosotros vamos a tener 2, nomás porque queremos hacerlo rápido, pero si ustedes quieren ponerle 8
yeah.
ojitos, pueden hacer eso, o si quieren ponerle más.
Yeah, you can make them realistic by adding more eyes if you wanted to. And this time we are going to use glue to put on the eyes.
Go first. Pueden poner los ojitos que estén chuecos, así que se vean chistosos si quieren.
You could also use glue dots if you wanted to. I'm going to try that out.
Yo tengo lentes, entonces yo le voy a dibujar unos lentes a mi araña. I
so
have glasses,
cute.
So I want to personalize my spider, so I'm just drawing some funny glasses.
Yours is a rare Isela spider, a rare North Texas Isela spider.
You don't see these spiders out in the wild, okay? Entonces, si mi arañita tiene lentes.
He may not have all 8 of his eyes, but he does have, he's got 4 eyes at least.
Sí.
Alright, so after, that looks great.
I wish you guys could see it. I drew on it with a black pen, so you might not be able to see it, but he has little glasses on.
Perfect. Okay, so now we're going to kind of work on the mechanism in the back of the spider that makes it go up and down on the string, and for that, we need our straws.
Okay, ahora vamos a tomar los popotes, chiquitos.
So you're just going to put them on the back of your spider, space them out a little bit, and you want them up and down and side by side.
Entonces los vamos a pegar atrás. No los peguen tan cerca. Es mejor que estén poquito alejados.
About an inch in between is probably good. I'm just doing a little tape over the whole straw.
Okay, lo estoy pegando aquí atrás.
No. While you work on that, I'm going to cut some string for us.
Thank you.
The length of the string doesn't really matter that much, but remember you are going to fold it in half. So make the length of your folded in half string about as high up as you want the spider to climb. So I'm doing, this is probably about 3 feet of twine in total.
Ahora recortamos el hilo y creo que se lo vamos a meter adentro del popote, ¿verdad?
Yes, yes. Yeah, we are going to put it inside of the straws. And you're just going to put it up through one straw and down through the other.
Lo vamos a meter en uno.
So I'm putting it, I don't know if y'all can really see this, but I'm putting it up through one and then taking that same end and going down through the other straw. It's hard to turn it around while I'm doing it.
Lo metí por abajo de
together. And you're going to tie each end of your string to the middle of a popsicle stick. So I'm going to grab two for you, Isela.
Entonces tomamos el hilo y luego lo amarramos a los palitos. Y los voy amarrando. These popsicle sticks are so cute.
Well, and we kind of talked about how you can tie it around something different if you don't have popsicle sticks at home. I was just thinking of something that would hold, the string so that it didn't go back through the straws. And I looked in my box of popsicle sticks and I thought these are perfect. They're so tiny.
Okay, entonces aquí lo estoy amarrando para que no se suelte.
Yeah, double knot is a good idea.
Lo voy a abrochar dos veces para que no se le caiga el palito. Y si no pueden amarrarlo en casa, le pueden preguntar a sus papás, mm-hmm. a su hermano, que si le pueden ayudar. So if you can't tie it, you can ask your parent or your brother and sister and help you tie it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
Perfect. Okay, so now our spiders are done, but we just need to put them up on a wall in order to make them actually move. So ask an adult for help with this step because you want to make sure you're not, putting the spider up on the wall where they don't want it. So you could just put like a little thumbtack in the wall and hang the loop on the top of the spider over that. Or you can do what we did and you could tape it up on the wall.
Hay muchas maneras de hacer que su arañita se mueva, pero lo tienen que poner sobre una pared. Le pueden preguntar a un adulto que les ayude a poner su arañita a lo mejor en un clavito que tengan mm-hmm. en la pared, o como nosotros hicimos aquí, lo pusimos en la pared y usamos tape para ponerlo aquí arriba y así lo podemos mover.
Mm-hmm. And we'll show you how it's going to move too. So you just grab one popsicle stick in each hand. You can stand and you don't need another person's help with this. You can just grab one with each hand, but you have to pull out to either side to get it to climb up.
Así se va a mover su arañita. Está muy chistosa. Es muy fácil hacer esto. Entonces, si lo hacen en casa, por favor, de tomar una foto o hacer un video.
Yeah.
Es muy fácil.
Mm-hmm. And all of this, of course, reminds me of a song. Do you know what song I'm thinking of, Isela?
I think so.
So if y'all know the song, The Itsy Bitsy Spider, we would like you to sing it with us. We're going to sing it in English and in Spanish. There are lots of different versions of The Itsy Bitsy Spider in Spanish. I know a particular one, but you might know a different one. So you can sing along with whatever lyrics it is that you know. So you want to sing the English version with me first, Isela?
Yeah.
Okay. The itsy bitsy spider went up the water spout. Down came the rain and washed the spider out. Up came the sun and dried up all the rain. And the itsy bitsy spider went up the spout again. Perfect, thank you. So you can do the motions with me while we sing the Spanish
yeah.
version too. The Spanish version is a little different. He's not climbing up the water spout. He's making his web, and the web keeps getting washed away by the rain. Okay, so the Spanish version goes, La itsy bitsy araña tejió su telaraña. Vino la lluvia y se la llevó. Salió el sol y se secó la lluvia. Itsy bitsy araña otra vez subió. Nursery rhymes are always really cute. All right, so I think we've got some announcements to end off with.
Yes, so my announcement for today is I want to invite you guys for Fired Up for Reading. That is on October 17th. And starting Monday, we'll have kits for that program in all three branches. So if you want to participate in that program and you want your own kit, be sure to come next week to any of the three libraries and you can pick up your kit there.
Yeah, and you can find out about all of our programs by coming and getting a program guide if you haven't done so already. And in that, you'll find out that next week we do have another installment of Homeschool Hub. And so you can email me for information about that, cplemons@gptx.org. And it's going to be at noon on Tuesday. So if you're homeschooling your kids and you haven't yet signed up for that, you can just let me know and you're welcome to join us. And we also have craft kits available at Shotwell Library next week. As usual, it's going to be a different craft every single week, so make sure you stop by anytime after school to pick up one of those free craft kits.
Well, I hope you guys have a great weekend. Thank you for joining us this morning. I hope to see you guys next week.
Yeah, thank y'all. Bye.